Hello guys, and welcome to episode 21 of my Total War Warhammer playthrough, playing as the vampire counts on very hard difficulty, and things are certainly getting difficult. Archeon has shown himself near Essen. The Ward Herd of Chaos is also heading down here. They have a full stack army near Essen. Over near Marienburg, there is two full stacks of scaling, and we're defending Marienburg with Helm and Gorst. We also have our rebellion pop there, which is actually helping us out, which is quite funny. As for the Crooked Moon, they're doing okay, and I would say dealing with the dwarves lightly, since we kind of are. But they're just kind of sitting in our lands. They're not actually attacking any settlements. All of our settlements are walled, so I think it's kind of off-putting for them. And it's just allowing the Crooked Moon to run around and pick up lands. But that's fine, because if we jump into diplomacy, we're now strength rank 1. I didn't actually realise that until I just checked just now, but yeah, apparently that's the case. So the dwarves, faltering slightly, they're at war with so many people. Hopefully the greenskins can take advantage of all of the armies coming down towards us. And in the meantime, I think everything was done, so we're going to move on to the next turn. Let's see what the dwarves do. So one army moved back to Calicern. One's still raiding in our lands. Essen is under siege by Archeon. Oh no. The Lord of Change is just behind them. Oh, things are not going to be fun. That's for sure. Oh, and the armies are just coming straight down onto us. This is horrible. This is really the doomed tides of chaos, isn't it? Crazy. Schwarzhafen being raided. Okay, so I guess what we're going to do is march towards Essen. We're going to march into Castle Tempelhof, and we're just going to have to take the defensive, because I don't think we're really in a position to move up to Essen and defend that. I mean, I'll probably fight it out against Archeon just to weaken him a little, but in general, my lord, that's not good. Alright, Mannfred's ready to do his quest, so let's get him into a safe location. Can we get him maybe towards Fjeldorf? I think I'll just move him away as far as I can. And we're going to do the quest battle. This won't give him the armor of Tempelhof, but it will tell us where it is. So we're going to teleport, and we're going to find this one out. So we have Slugger and Nurjug. Let's fight this one on the battle map.
Poor minions, even in death. I would have this land for mine studies. And yet, I am pestered by these filthy creatures. I shall play the role of exterminator and wipe these orcs out.
And there we have it. Mannfred, not a fan of orcs. Let's get our skeletons up in front. We'll keep the crypt ghouls behind with the sternsmen. Keep skeleton warriors on the flanks, because they did have reinforcements of like cavalry. We have plenty of dire wolves though to take care of those, and that can be our setup. Let's lock that. We'll move towards the enemy. You are sitting on a hill, and we'll speed things up. Enemy reinforcements approaching. Coming around behind us, I assume. We're just going to keep moving away from them until we can see them. or green skin vermin approach. I mean, they don't actually have many melee forces, so we can just run down the rest of them with our direwolves. So what are they? Savage orc boar boys running up behind us. It's fine. Okay, so we're just going to pause it here, and what I'm going to do is target their forces. So let's get the troll attacked. We'll get the skeleton warriors to attack those savage orc boy biggins and the savage orcs there. Actually, let's attack those savage orcs with that one. We're going to need probably Vlad to take on the giant, and we'll get Melissa to help him out. Then the skeleton spearmen can turn around and protect our flanks, whilst the crypt ghouls run forwards and help us out as well. Okay. And the devils of Schwarzhafen, they can crash down into some of these archers. Then we'll get probably the Verex Reavers to turn round. Maybe the Chillgeist to turn around as well. And then we'll have all of the direwolves split. We'll get two to go right, and we'll get two to go left. And then that is our army moving away. Okay, cool. What unit did we not move? Just the Sturmsmen. So we'll get the Sturmsmen to engage, probably just in the centre, I guess. Okay, so we'll get the spearmen to attack some of these savage orc boar boys for us, and we'll move our mortise engine forwards, engage the trolls on the left. We're gonna spirit leech the giant, and I think I might do enfeebling foe onto the giant as well. Then we're gonna get our direwolves to run into these arches and crush them completely. Good stuff. Right, let's attack Slugger. It looks like I should probably get my Vargeists and the Dire Pack out of that engagement. All of the archers are dead, which is a good start. We can do a double invocation here, actually. Probably needs an invocation on this self. Let's go for the Wind of Death onto some of these savage orcs. Not entirely sure what that does, but should help out the Sturmsmen. Okay, that was different to what I thought it would do. Well, let's get into the back of this engagement. Oh my. Mannfred very low. Getting wrecked by the by the giant. Looks like Melissa might go down. We'll go for an invocation onto Mannfred, and he can spirit leech the giant. Over here, what's going on? Ferex Reaver succeeded. Okay, so we can get them to turn around. Chill guys doing their best. We did lose a unit. Alright, so we've succeeded in the center there. Let's kill the giant now. I think we lost a unit of... Yeah, we lost the unit of... direwolves. Oh my. Mannfred taking a lot of damage. Spirit leech the giant again. We'll charge back in there. Right, since that engagement has succeeded, just finish off things where we can. Get these spearmen back to help out our main line. But everything's pretty much done over here. Yep, they're all routed. Oh, looks like the majority of their main forces have routed as well. And that should be victory. Good stuff. We're going to end the battle there. That was a close one. Certainly was. I mean, I guess we had it under control, but it was very close to having Mannfred killed there. That wouldn't have been ideal. Plenty of loot gained. Probably going to take even more. We lost a unit of Skeleton Warriors and the Regiment of Renown. And we get 3,000 for completing that. So, with the Savage Orcs routed, Count Mannfred draws upon his dark arts, dragging the reluctant spirit of the dead Nahakaran King back to the surface. It seems that the King's army was scattered by a sudden sandstorm and slain by a horde of greenskins. The greenskin warboss, Grudsnik, stripped the King's corpse of the magnificent armor. The spirit knows no more, and Count Mannfred releases it. The name of Grudsnik is known to the Vampire Lord. Grudsnik the Magnificent was once the scourge of Bretonnia. Such was his reputation that his followers built a great burial mound for him, protected by shamanic fetishes. Such wards are of little concern to Mannfred, and now he sends the necromancer west to scout out the area. So we've got to deploy a necromancer in Carcassonne now, which is actually quite easy since we are already over here with Bernd. So Bernd is deploying this turn to build things in Musalon. So we'll upgrade to the Balefire Hearth and get the gibbet there. May as well upgrade the Murky Harbour while we're there to get more income. Looks like Scaling moved on to attacking Caron.
Lord of the dead.
Find me grave power.
Right, what else can we do? So I might get Paulus Gorst to head up towards Castle Tempelhof, and we're going to deploy. We'll get Steiner to head his way back up as well. Eric von Carstein, of course, going to head and help out with the public order. That was his plan. And Helmut Gorst holding his ground in Marienburg for now. So that is everything for this turn. Let's move on to the next one. And now, with every turn that ends, it's very likely that more things are going to go wrong. We've got more dwarves arriving on our doorstep. But before that happens, Essen is under attack by Archeon and Sithoriel. My lord, that's a lot of hell cannons. That's like 7 hell cannons. Like, really? Do you need that many? We can do damage to these armies though, so let's fight this on the battle map. Okay, here we are. So, I mean, it looks relatively simple, right? balance bar is actually relatively close, but definitely not the case. The Chaos Trolls can knock on the gates, that's for sure. The plan, really, is to use our Felbats and Vargeists to attack the Hellcannons, but before I do so, I'm just going to keep them at the back of the settlement. We're going to keep our Black Knights probably in the centre bit here, so they're protected by the walls, and we may as well get the Black Knights with Lances and Barding there as well. The Chaos Trolls, or Crypt Horrors, sorry, can protect the gates. And basically we want all of these towers to be firing, so we need to spread out our forces so that that happens. We'll get our unit onto the wall there. Actually, we probably want... How am I going to do this? Let me just get them off the wall. We get one unit to spread out and capture both towers on that right side. Also stops them getting focused down so easily by the hell cannons. We're going to get crypt ghouls to go in the center. Actually, we'll get zombies in the center. We'll get zombies on this tower as well. Then crypt ghouls can protect the left side. Is that everything? Yeah, that's everything. Okay, let's start the battle. We'll get the towers to attack their towers. Maybe we can take down a couple of them before they get here. That's the plan. Because the less they have coming up the walls, the more of a chance we have of doing damage. Of course, the chaos troll there is just going to come straight at us, or the giant. And since they've pretty much left their hell cannons already, although the hell cannons are just getting free here at the moment by my tower, so that's fine. These towers do a lot of damage, which is why I'm making sure that I have them all activated. I think one of the hell cannons was destroyed. Yeah, it was. So now we're targeting the other one. So that siege tower is going to get to the walls, which means I'm going to have to move over my crypt horrors. I'm going to have one get to the wall here, so let's group up my units more. They're chaos warriors, so should be it should be a relatively good fight for our greatsword infantry. Want to attack that hell cannon with the tower, and these towers can attack hell cannons all the way at the back. They have broken through the gates, so let's attack the chaos trolls with all of our black knights and so on. And let's get the vargeists and so on to come and help us out. I might actually come down onto these chaos trolls and chaos knights with all of our flying units, rather than attacking the hell cannons, because I think we can hit the hell cannons with all of our towers. Right, we're doing a lot of damage to these chaos warriors anyway, I think, which is good. Chaos trolls are running away. It's a good start. Gonna focus the other chaos trolls now. May as well get these crypt ghouls actually to come down off the walls, since that tower can't fire at anything. May as well get these zombies to move as well. Actually, I'll there is some ladders going up there for Archaon. Right, have we destroyed those hell cannons? Yes, we have. Okay, so let's target the other hell cannons now. Ah, they've captured that tower. That's not good. Let's attack Chaosborn instead. Maybe we'll attack the Chaos Knights. So we're going to do a lot of damage. This will probably be like a valiant defeat just because of how much damage we are doing. Let's attack the Chaos Giant. Get rid of that. If we can. Doing loads of damage to the Chaos Knight unit. Unfortunately, we're not capping this tower anymore. So, we've destroyed, what, 5 Hell Cannons? I think that's probably good enough. Towers are just so overpowered. I don't know why the Hell Cannons are coming up on the walls there. We have Chaos Warriors with Halberds fighting our zombies. Oh my. Chaos Warriors with Halberds coming in, that's not very nice. Let's get the Chaos Trolls, or the Cryptora, sorry, to just keep the engagement going there. I'm actually going to fly off with the Vargeist. And then we're going to charge into the back of those Halberdiers. Or Chaos, or Chosen with great weapons. They're not very nice to deal with. A lot of our units faltering now. But the Chaos Knights there, gonna be very dead. Doing loads of damage to that giant, which is good. Although we did just lose control of that tower. And it looks like, unfortunately, guys, that is our loss right there. One of the units disintegrating and a close defeat. So, we destroyed, I think, 5 Hell Cannons. Hopefully. Did a lot of damage with the forces that we had. Nah, we only destroyed 2. I guess it was still worth fighting. And Essen's gonna be raised. It's not very fun. They're coming straight for us.
Night grows long.
The Jaggedhorn tribe would like a defensive alliance, but we are going to reject that. Ward Herd of Chaos didn't attack us, so that was quite surprising. I thought they might. Top knots have been destroyed by the dwarves. Settlement raised, Essen. Castle Templehof has negative growth. Okay. So over here, let's see what's going on. Where did the war herd go? I think if I move towards Waldenhof, they're going to ambush me. No, they didn't. Okay, we're good. So Vlad can stick around in Castle Templehof. We're actually going to change these zombies probably to some better units. We may as well, since we're here. Maybe some more Vargeists would be fun. Or maybe some Vargolfs. See, let's get the Königstein Stalkers into Vlad's army now, and then we'll build the Vargolf there. Right, Mannfred, since he's done, we might march him over to Castle Drakenhof, and then from there I'll recruit some more units. Some more elite units into his army.
Do you need
right, and Ben's done with his building in Musalon, I believe. So we can move him down to Carcassonne in order to complete our quest. And, well, once all of these buildings are finished, hopefully I'll be able to move out Hamlin, but not yet.
I will alone. Darkness comes.
We might be able to move out Oswald soon.
Master of the dead.
Hellman is chilling in Marienburg. Let's level him up. What does Morbid Reunion do? Minus red debt, raise dead cost. It's useful, but probably not at the moment. We'll go for Aura of Supremacy. Paulos Gorst. I think we'll just keep him by Castle Templehof for now. Steiner can move up. Erik is still heading towards Carcassonne. And then that's everything done for this turn, I believe. Let's move on to the next one. I'm always scared to press the end turn button at the moment. It's very tense. Like, at any moment, the dwarves could attack me. We could have Chaos come down and decide to attack me. And it looks like that's what's going to happen. Chaos going for the attack on Waldenhof. Pretty crazy stuff. Nothing else happening though? No, we're good. Okay. So, Waldenhof, Eastern Sylvania. Okay, loads of raiding going on, but that's fine. So Mannfred has a corpse pile. I'm just worried about where this Varg army is going. I think all of these settlements are fine. Mannfred should be able to defend against that army. I would hope it would. Just that none of these newer provinces that I have any defenses yet. So if like a Varg army manages to come all the way down here, we're going to be in trouble. Either way, Bernd can complete our quest this turn. We can deploy in that settlement. Hamlin's still chilling. And I think since we can now build the gibbet, we're going to do so, and we'll upgrade to the Balefire Hearth. And then we will move Oswald out of Castle Carcassonne and begin to head him north. Yeah, it's going to be minus 6, but I think it will sort itself out eventually. If not, then I might have to just travel back, and that's fine. Meanwhile, Mannfred, marching towards Castle Drakenhof. I might just put him into normal stance next turn. We'll get Vlad maybe to cancel his recruitment and come over and help. I kind of want to check if he can. He's definitely in range, yeah. To help Heinrich Kemmler. If we advance onto them, we actually have a pretty good chance of winning. I'm not sure quite what happened to Archeon's army, but he's lost a lot of men. I mean, I know we fought really well in that last battle, but I don't think we destroyed that many units, unless he like merged them or something. The thing is, our army is very, very strong. A lot of Graveguard. A lot of these Black Knights, Lancers, and Barding, which actually fend off these other units very well, like the Chaos Spawn and the Chaos Trolls. Right, we're going to decline that attack. Stay behind our walls. I think we'll wait for Vlad to get the Vargolf, and then we'll attack. If they attack Waldenhof next turn, we can defend that easily. I think with one army. So we should be okay against Chaos now, which is a good thing. Then once we've dealt with Chaos, I guess maybe we can start heading north and start settling a lot of these provinces. Like a lot of these raised provinces. For example, we have Telebuk land here, the Kemperbad's raised. We could take basically all of Middenland for another free province. That would be something to do once we fend off Archeon and so on. Still have Calakern as the Crooked Moon's objective, but I haven't seen their armies for a while. There's one here, Skarsnik, hanging around near Calakizor. I wish they would replenish their men and actually be useful. That would be helpful. But yeah, Heinrich Kemmler can't do anything. Helmand Gorst can't do anything. Vlad, Hamlin, they all can't do anything. So it's pretty much just moving straight on to the next turn again. Steiner heading up here. I might leave him in this province to spread vampiric corruption. The winds blow death our way. And Erik can continue on his way to Carcassonne. So actually he will get to Carcassonne in time to help us with the public order anyway. Let's move on to the next turn.
would them?
Well, the dwarves would like a peace treaty. This generally means, though, that they feel like they're going to lose. So we're going to decline. This is when they attack me and they win. They did actually just siege one of my settlements. So, let's see what happens. Where's the war herd gone? I don't like not seeing them move. It makes me wonder what's going on. Plenty of raiding happening though, and we did complete the quest. So now we have the battle, another quest battle for the armor of Tempelhof. The necromancer sends word that Grudsnik's mound lies to the east of Castle Carcassonne, whose duke commands a powerful garrison. Doubtless, this puny mortal will try to interfere with Manfred's plans, but no matter, his corpse will serve the Count as well as that of any other man. So we'll get the armor of Tempelhof if we succeed. Extra experience. It's a Bretonian expedition. Plenty of field trebuchets, which we can run down pretty easily. Like, their actual standard force is pretty terrible. So I think Mannfred could deal with that. Thing is, I do want to send Mannfred back to defend Fildorf, since it's under attack. So we'll head back to Averheim. I guess we'll raise dead from Averheim. Ooh, look at that. We can get a Vargolf. Yep, definitely raising the dead next turn. But unfortunately, guys, it has been my time, so I'm going to have to leave it here. It's been pretty good episode, I guess. Not in terms of progression, but in terms of like seeing where things are going to end. Chaos will get destroyed, probably, in the assault of Waldenhof, so that'll be good. And then we can get Mannfred to save us from the dwarves. Then we can probably sort out a public order in the Bretonian provinces and move away from them to attack the dwarves. But we'll have to see as we move on. In the meantime, that's all. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.